iRobot is known for its wireless automated vacuums. The Roomba does the dirty work, sweeping floors so you don't have to. But iRobot isn't just focused on a clean house. Headquartered in Bedford, the company is also expanding the curriculum for its children's coding robot, Root.
Root starts out with a graphical programming language. And so even the littlest of kids can see the pictures and know how to move them on the screen and start making the robot move.
The Root has a total of 3 learning levels that allow kids to advance as their skill level grows.
What did you just add here? What is that?
It's the marker, so it makes it draw on the pad.
Oh, so that's the one that actually pulls the marker down?
Yeah.
Sam is 6 years old and already coding on his own.
I'm gonna make a snowman.
Through Root's coding programs, kids are learning lessons in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math. Lisa Freed is iRobot's STEM program manager.
The kids who are in school need to learn that teamwork, that cooperation, the communication is really a big part of how you're gonna solve STEM problems.
The Root Learning Library recently expanded to incorporate social-emotional learning into its lessons.
You each only have one piece of the solution.
With Root, we've designed a bunch of activities based on making decisions, on fairness, on communication, on listening, and that's the skill set that we're able to give them and sort of gamify it by having them use the robot to learn.
Social-emotional learning is a key part of human development, helping children acquire the tools to manage emotions, maintain relationships, and achieve goals.
And you can also change how far you want to move or how much you want to turn.
SEL can be a challenge in a remote classroom environment, but iRobot is working to make it easier.
We have the project sharing feature that allows teachers to build a program out, send it to their students, and then say, hey, can you build upon this program? Mm-hmm. And then send it back to us so we can send it to another student, have them build upon it as well.
An exercise in coding with a much larger lesson plan built in.
So there's a huge element of collaboration there where students can collaborate on the same coding project to build something greater.
Joe Jones loves gardening, but like most of us, hates weeding. And since he wants to grow an organic garden, he's avoiding herbicides, toxic chemicals used to kill weeds.
I'd like to get herbicides out of agriculture. If you build a robot correctly, if you build the robot so that it's inexpensive enough, I think that we can do that.
So Joe, a former engineer at iRobot, decided to use his skills to create Turtle, a robot that lives in the garden and runs on sunshine. Turtle is like a little weed whacker, cutting off small weeds before they have a chance to grow and choke off your plants. It does it by capacitive sensing. As it travels near a plant, it measures minute changes in electrical fields and moves in a different direction.
The sensor creates an electric field, and it measures the change in that field caused by anything that's a little bit conductive.
When it finds an intruder, it activates to quickly cut it out. And to prevent Turtle from turning your lettuce leaves into chopped salad prematurely, there are these little row grids. They protect your vegetables until they grow tall enough.
One of the best ones was this guy who said it was the first time in 32 years that he had come back from vacation and not found that his garden had turned into a jungle.
Turtle is weatherproof, solar powered, and recharges itself.
Sits around in the sun until the battery charges up enough, and then it runs for a while.
An unexpected benefit, it also keeps garden pests away.
I saw one chipmunk jump into my garden when the robot was moving, and it took off rapidly in another direction.
To prove how effective Turtle is, Joe planted a garden 2 weeks ago. He added 20,000 weed seeds, then divided the garden in two. One side has weeds, and you can see what the turtle did to the other side. Turtle started as an idea 6 years ago and just started shipping last year.
It's gotten more popular even since COVID has come along and people are spending more time in their backyard. They need something to do and something to do with the kids.
And when you take away the chore of weeding, families can enjoy spending more time together in the garden.
Because then you can get excited about the plants growing and the fruit developing and whatever, and you don't have to think, oh, but I have to go and weed.
Right now, the base model turtle is selling for $349. Jones and his team are working on a version that will work with flower beds and landscaped areas as well. And back to iRobot, for kids who may not have access to the Root device, they can access some of its programming online with a tablet, laptop, or computer. And a lot of that programming is also available in multiple languages. Up next, can steel production go green?